Hello everyone, you are welcome in the second lecture in the Principles of Plant Pathology. Today we have to talk about the parasitism and the pathogenicity, the steps of the disease cycle including infection, colonization, reproduction and survival, and the end we can say some points about the disease development. At the beginning we must know some definitions. What's the difference between parasitism and pathogenicity? For example, parasite is an organism that lives on or in some other organism and obtains its food from the host. That means these parasites is living organism but cannot make their food, and it depends on other host to take their food. If this parasite make relation with host and harm the host, that means we change the relationship from parasite to pathogen and pathogenicity. And after that, this is living microorganism make or develop disease on their host. Sometimes these parasites make a symbiosis on their host. That means both plant and microorganism benefit from the association. We can classify the parasite according to the way of their feeding into host, into obligate parasite and non-obligate parasite. What the meaning of obligate parasite, or sometimes known also pyotrophs? This type of pathogen don't kill plant cell, and they penetrate the cell wall and establish a continuous relationship and move from cell to cell without damage the plant cell of host, such as fungi, virus, viroid, and nematodes, but not all the fungi. Some fungus can live only on their host as pyotrophs, for example powdery mildew, downy mildew, and rusts. On other hand, we have other type of living from pathogen on, their host, known as non-obligate parasites. And also this type classified into two groups, facultative parasites and facultative saprophytes. If the pathogen are facultative parasites, usually grows and complete life cycle on dead material, but sometimes can do so on living tissue. Facultative saprophytes usually grows and complete life cycle on living tissue, but under some conditions can do so on dead materials. يبقى ده معناه ان احنا عندنا أي كائن لا يستطيع أن يكون غذائه بنفسه فهو بيتطفل على كائن آخر ليحصل على الغذاء، فده بنسميه الباراسايت. إذا كان الباراسايت دوت هيعمل دامج، هيحصل على الغذاء ويضر العائل بتاعه، اتحول الحالة دي اسمه باثوجين، وبقى عندنا الباثوجينيسيتي. الباثوجينز أو الباراسايت أنا بقسمهم على حسب طبيعة حصولهم على الغذاء من العائل لنوعين، لا اما اوبليجيت باراسايت وبسميها بايوتروفس، او نان اوبليجيت باراسايت. الاوبليجيت باراسايت ده الباثوجين اللي بيحصل على الغذاء بتاعه من العائل دون ان يموت او يضر خليه العائل باي ضرر، عايز دايما العائل حي، زي بعض الفطريات زي الباودري ميلدو والداوني ميلدو والراست، او الفيروسس كلها. طبعا الفيروس كلها ما بتموتش العائل بتاعها، عايزاه حي. الفيرويد والنيماتودز. بعض الانواع الاخرى من الباثوجين اللي بتعيش بطريقه نون اوبليجيت باراسايت ممكن ان هي تكون فاكولتيتيف باراسايت او فاكولتيتيف سابروفايتس. الفاكولتيتيف باراسايت هي اساسا بتعيش على الاجزاء الميته، لكن في جزء من دورات حياتها ممكن ان هي تنتقل وتدخل الى العائل الحي زي النباتات. اما الفاكولتيتيف العكس، هي عايشه اوريدي دايما على العائل الحي، بس لفتره ما مش هتلاقي العائل الحي فتقوم عايشه على الاجزاء الميته. المهم في الاخر عندنا ان الانفكشس ديزيز ايجنتس بنسميها ايه؟ باثوجينز، وهي دي اللي بتبقى قادره على احداث الاصابه. we have also two different scientific definitions, disease and pathogenicity. Disease is the process in which a pathogen interferes with more one or more essential plant infection function. But pathogenicity, that means the ability of pathogen to interfere with one or more of the essential plant function. Now we have to talk about the disease development. The occurrence of plant disease vary from season to season to seasons, depending on the presence of the pathogen, environmental conditions, and the crops and varieties grown. Some plants varieties are particularly subject to outbreaks of disease, while others are more resistant to them. That means at the end, we have almost three main factors that can play a role to develop the disease. The first factor is host, the second is pathogen, the third is the environmental condition. If these three factors associated with together, that means we have at the end disease. If we break one of these factor or affect on the one of these factors, we can management or make resistance of plant disease. As you will see here in this picture, we put these three factors as a triangle, and we know that as a triangle disease. One side of the triangle is the pathogen, the second side is environment, and the third is host. And to achieve and make success disease, we must find the susceptible host and also have aggressive pathogen, and we have at the end a favorable condition or the environmental condition to make plant disease. When can we see the disease development? If we have a disease cycle, the disease pathogens the pathogenesis is the stage of disease in which the pathogen is in association with the living host tissue. And actually we have some stages. In this stage, the pathogen contact with plant tissue. The first one is inoculation, when the pathogen initial spores transfer to the plant surface and try to break the plant surface or enter the plant tissue by wounds or natural opening, and after that start to call invasion of the tissue, and this is the second stage. After the invasion of the plant tissue, the pathogen try to colonize the organ of plant. After colonization, that means the pathogen is success to make infection. And after a short time, we can see some symptoms on the infected plant. And when we see symptoms, that means we have actually diseased plant. And the step after the symptoms appear, the pathogen start to produce structures, different structures that help them to survive in soil or in the air or in other hosts, and make an inoculum, new inoculum, which can disperse and make new infection on other hosts. This is the disease cycle of any pathogen, a series of events that occur during pathogenic relationship of a pathogen and the host that leads to disease. يبقى الرسمة اللي قدامنا بتوضح لنا الديزيز سايكل وازاي المرض بيحصل على النبات. الإصابة بتبدأ أولا في ثلاث مراحل أساسية. إن أول حاجة لازم يحصل infection، ودي اللي بيحصل فيها ان الانيشال سبورس او الانيشال انوكيلم اللقاح الاولي للمسبب المرضي لما بيوصل لسطح العائل النباتي ويبدا ان هو يدخل ويعمل انفيشن للتيشو بتاع النبات. دي العلاقه الاوليه اللي بيدخل منها المسبب للنبات، وطبعا فيها بيتغلب المسبب على سطح النبات اللي هو الجدار الخلوي، او ان هو يدخل من خلال الفتحات الطبيعيه او الجروح. بعد دخوله لازم ان هو يعمل كولونايزيشن، يستعمر بقى الانسجه ويتواصل في استمراره في نموه داخل انسجه النبات. بعد فتره قصيره من الكولونايزيشن بيبدا يظهر عندي السيمبتومز، اللي هي لما بشوفها ببدا اتعرف بقى ان هنا حصل ايه انفكشن على النبات، وان انا عندي نبات مريض. كل اللي فات ده انا ما بشوفوش بعيني المجرده، ده ممكن تحت الميكروسكوب ابدا اشوف الاستادي، لكن انا ما بشوفش في الحقيقه على النبات وجود الجراثيم وان هي دخولها. لكن وانس ان انا بشوف السيمبتومز يبقى انا كده خلاص عرفت النبات مصاب. بعد مرحله السيمبتومز المسبب المرضي بيبدا ينتج الاستراكشرز المختلفه اللي تساعده ان هو يعمل بقاء في التربه او على عوائل اخرى، والفتره دي بيبدا يديني انوكيلم جديد ينتقل ويعمل انفكشن جديد على عوائل مختلفه. تعالوا كده ناخد مرحله مرحله ونشوف ايه اللي هيحصل في الديزيز ديفلوبمنت. As you know, when pathogen comes in contact with plant, that's known as infection. And pathogen can infect the plant or penetrate the plant by direct or indirect way. And some pathogen needs vectors to transmit the pathogen in the plant tissue. After that, each pathogen need incubation period, that means the time between penetration and first appearance of symptoms. During this incubation period, pathogen start to colonize the tissue of plant. After that, pathogen increases within plant, uses host to grow and reproduce. And we can see at the end of this stage the symptoms on the infected plant. Here we start to know some ways used by pathogen to enter in the plant. Each pathogen differ from other for the way to enter the plant. For example, virus and viroid require vectors or wounds on the plant surface to enter the plant tissue. Bacteria enters through natural opening or wounds. Fungi enters through natural opening, wounds, mechanical pressure, enzyme, and sometimes need also vectors to enter. Nematodes use the style to gain entry of the plant roots. Invasion. This is the stage of disease cycle which known other in this stage pathogen start to colonize the plant tissue, and each pathogen differ from other to make invasion in the plant host. For example, apple scape grow between the cuticle and epidermis. Other pathogen such as powdery mildew grow on the surface and send hysteria into cell. Because powdery mildew is obligate parasite, that means it need almost a living host and cannot kill the plant cell. Therefore, it grows between the cells and send hysteria into the cell to absorb their food. Vascular wealth invades the xylem vessels, not between the cells, only in the xylem. Most nematodes are intercellular or intracellular, and some don't invade at all but feed from the surface of the root. Virus, viroid invade by moving from cell to cell. That means at the end, each pathogen has different way to make colonization in the plant tissue. The growth and the reproduction of the pathogen in this stage of disease cycle, pathogen start to make new reproductive unit to continue for the transmission from the host to other. For example, fungi produce spores, sexual or asexual spores. High parasitic plants produce seeds. Bacteria and molecules can produce a new individual bacterial cell by binary fusion. Virus and viroid replicate in the cell like photocopy and make new particles. And the nematodes can produce eggs, and this is continual for developing the new nematodes and make a new infection in new host. After that, when pathogen success to make invasion and colonization and produce new survival structures, started to spread their survival in soil or air to reach for a new other host. For example, some fungus can disperse by wind or others by splashing during rain or irrigation. But others need swim or move in the soil, such as nematodes. Other pathogen can be associated with seed, internal or external on the seeds. Also, the infection can transmit during plant materials, cutting, grafting. Other type of the pathogen known as soil-borne pathogen, that means they are don't produce a unit or spores, dispersal with air, only still stay in the soil and start the new infection in the soil. After the pathogen finished for producing the structure, survival structures, these structures can produce two types of inoculum, either primary inoculum or secondary inoculum. Primary inoculum, this is a unit or prime inoculum can overwinter and invades plant in the spring or fall and cause primary infection. And this is inoculum responsible for the starting of the infection. But if the pathogen can make a new spores or new inoculum during the growing season, and this is inoculum can spread from the infected plant to healthy one and make a new infection on the plant during the same growing season, that means the secondary inoculum. المرحلة ديت في الانوكيوليشن ان زي ما اتفقنا احنا عندنا اكتر من مرحلة او اكتر من ستيج في دورة المرض. ان المسبب المرضي بيبدأ بالتعامل مع العائل في الانفكشن وبعدين بيغزوه وينتج الاعراض، ثم يبدأ ان هو يحس ان خلاص النبات ده هيبدأ يموت، فيبدأ يكون وحدات التكاثر بتاعته اللي هتنتشر بعد كده وتحول الاصابة جديدة. مجرد ما بينتهي المسبب المرضي من تكوين وحدات التكاثر، الوحدات التكاثر دي يا اما انا بسميها برايمري انوكيلم او سكندري انوكيلم. اذا المسبب المرضي ده بينتج وحده التكاثر مره وهي دي اللي بتبقى بدايه الاصابه دايما، وعاده بتكون الاصابه بدايتها في الربيع او الخريف، وهي ديت الوحده اللي اتحملت كل الظروف البيئيه الغير مناسبه، فانا بسميها البرايمري انوكيلم، وهي دي اللي بتبدا بيها الاصابه الاوليه على النبات اللي هي البرايمري انفكشن. اما اذا كان الباثوجين دوت بينتج عندي مجموعه من اللقاح المستمر في اثناء فتره نمو النبات وهو لسه النبات ما بداش يموت، والباثوجين عمال ينتج في لقاحات مستمره، واللقاح ده بينتقل من النبات المصاب للنبات السليم في نفس موسم النمو، فانا بسميها سكندري انوكيلم. يبقى هو ما عملش اوفر وينترنج وما عداش فتره ظروف بيئيه غير مناسبه، لا ده هو الظروف البيئيه مناسبه وهو على العائل عمال يدي وحدات تكاثر اكتر عشان يوسع الانتشار بتاعه، فبسميه ايه؟ سكندري انوكيلم. Now we reach to the last stage in the disease cycle, dispersal. Spread of inoculum depends on two ways. Either pathogen placed in the soil and we put a healthy plant in infected soil so the pathogen can invade or can make disease on the healthy plant. Or inoculum moves from its source to host plant by wind, by splashing, by different way. But this is the two ways which mean we can reach the pathogen to the plant and make contact and start the disease cycle. The last part in our lectures, we can talk about the relationship between disease cycle and epidemics. We have two different types of disease cycle: monocyclic epidemics and polycyclic epidemics. In monocyclic epidemics, inoculum comes from a reservoir, and hence amount of inoculum for a given season crop is fixed. So there is no repetition of the disease cycle within the crop season, and hence the disease spread will be slow. For example, soil diseases were caused by Rhizoctonia, Pisium, Sclerotium. This is the type of infection of monocyclic disease. But polycyclic disease or polycyclic epidemics, in this type of disease, inoculum is multiplied several times. Every 7 to 15 days for wheat rust can produce a new inoculum during crop growth in a season, and the disease spread will be fast. For example, wheat stem rust or powdery mildew disease of different crops. As you see here in this diagram, the represent primary disease cycle. The pathogen starts the infection by the primary inoculum and cause the primary infection. Still, pathogen invade plant and make colonization till the end of the growing season. And at the end of growing plant growing season, produce the primary or overwintering structures. This is can survive in the soil and stay in the soil till a new crop become and make a new infection. That means we have only one infection during the season, growing season. Start with primary infection and ending with overwintering, which can overcome the unfavorable conditions. And when we find the host, start again to make a primary infection and make the disease. Such an example for this is root rots. But other type, polycyclic disease, as you see, here the infection starts with the primary infection by primary inoculum. And during the growing season on the plant, the pathogen started to produce a lot of number of spores or a lot of number of inoculum, known as secondary inoculum. This secondary inoculum can be transferred or transmit from the infected plant to healthy one and make a new infection on other host and make secondary infection. At the end of the growing season, can pathogen make overwintering structures and or still produce the secondary inoculum and spread from this area to other area and make infection on a larger area in short time. This is the post different type of disease according to epidemic of this disease. يبقى احنا عندنا نوعين من دورات الحياة بتاعت المسبب المرضي تبعا لوبائية المرض، لا اما monocyclic disease او polycyclic disease. المونوسايكليك ديزيز المسبب المرضي بيبدا الاصابه باللقاح الاولي ويستمر طول فتره نمو النبات بداخله، ما يعملش لقاح تاني غير في اخر نمو موسم النمو، يعمل لقاح اللي هو يقدر يتحمل الظروف البيئيه الغير مناسبه او ان الوعاء خلاص هنشيله من الارض. لما نحط عائل جديد والانفكشن بتاعي موجود لسه في الارض والاستراكشر بتاعت الباثوجين موجوده، يبدا يعمل برايمري انفكشن تاني ويعمل انتقال للايه؟ للمرض. يبقى هو بيكمل المرض في دوره حياه واحده فقط لا غير. اما البولي سايكليك ديزيز ده المسبب المرضي، هنا بقى ذكي، يدخل العائل وبعد ما بيدخل من خلال البرايمري انفكشن يبدا يعمل لقاح جديد وهو لسه على العائل، وما عائل ما ماتش يعمل لقاح جديد ينقله على نبات جديد تاني، والنبات الجديد يخلص يقوم عامل لقاح جديد ينقله على نبات تالت. تلاقوا بقى النباتات عماله تزيد جدا في الاصابه على مستوى الارض، وممكن يتنقل من الارض للارض اللي جنبه للارض اللي جنبه في مساحات كبيره على فتره قصيره، فيعمل لي خطوره جامده جدا. يبقى ده بسميه البولي سايكليك ديزيز، انه بيكون لي نوعين من اللقاح في فتره المرض الواحده، برايمري انوكيلم وسكندري انوكيلم. أتمنى أن أنا أراكم إن شاء الله في المحاضرة القادمة على خير، وتكونوا فهمتوا الجزء اللي فات كويس جدا وهضمتوه إن شاء الله.